Good morning.
Thank you.
with the radiance of Christ's glory, that he may be known, worshiped, and obeyed to the ends of the earth, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Reading from the first book of Samuel. Now the boy Samuel was ministering to the Lord under Eli. The word of the Lord was rare in those days. Israel was not widespread. At that time Eli, whose eyesight had begun to grow dim so that he could not see, was lying down in his room. The lamp of God had not yet gone out, and Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord where the ark of God was. Then the Lord called, "Samuel, Samuel." And he said, "Here I am." And ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called." But he said, "I did not call you. Lie down again." So he went and lay down. And the Lord called again, "Samuel." Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called." But he said, "I did not call you, son. Lie down again." Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, and the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. The Lord called upon Samuel again, a third time. And he got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." Then Eli perceived that the Lord was calling the boy. Therefore Eli said to Samuel, "Go, lie down. And because you shall say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down in his place. Now the Lord came and stood there, calling as before, "Samuel, Samuel." And Samuel said, "Speak, for your servant is listening." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. All things are lawful for me, but not all things are beneficial. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be dominated by anything. Food is meant for the stomach, and the stomach for food, and God will destroy both one and the other. The body is meant not for fornication, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. And God raised the Lord and will also raise us by his power. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ? Should I therefore take the members of Christ and make them members of a prostitute? Never. Do you not know that whoever is united to a prostitute becomes one body with her? For it is said, the two shall become one flesh. But if anyone united to the Lord becomes one spirit with him, shun fornication. Every sin that a person commits is outside the body, but the fornicator sins against the body itself. Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, which you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you were bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The greatest gift we can give to others is not material possessions, but the gift of ourselves. It is only through our love and service that we can truly make a difference in this world. Amen. What is a circle tail? I had no clue until my early 30s, but while serving at an elementary school, I became obsessed with collecting picture books. And after reading this one in chapel, a colleague approached with two thumbs up and said, "Great circle tail." And I smiled and nodded like I knew what she was talking about. But I didn't. We've all been in situations like that one, right? Scurrying back to my computer, I researched how you craft a circle tale. You choose a setting, you introduce a main character, you then have that person go on an adventure, and then you have that individual, at the end of the journey, return to the same place where they began. In Beautiful Bananas, Beatrice travels to her grandfather's house with a gift, some beautiful bananas. Unfortunately, along the way, various animals accidentally destroy whatever gift she happens to be carrying, and this repetitive pattern emerges. Gift, destruction, restoration. A giraffe's tail sends the bananas into the river. So the giraffe apologizes and gives her flowers. Bees crush the flowers, they give her honey, monkeys steal the honey, they give her mangoes, whoops, bananas are at the end, sorry. And so on, until finally it's actually the elephant that destroys the colorful feather and then gives the bananas, and Beatrice is back. She ends where she began. You know, my ministry at Grace Church is a circle tale. It's no accident that I end my journey on Martin Luther King Day weekend, because 2011, Martin Luther King Day weekend, is when all this began. 13 years ago this weekend, my former husband and I flew from D.C. to be interviewed by you, and after boarding the plane and buckling my seatbelt, I turned to Brent and said, "Don't worry, we're just placating these people. We're going to have a romantic, snowy weekend. There is absolutely no way we are ever moving to New Hampshire." Y'all know one of my self-coined phrases: never say never in front of a forever God. And sure enough, upon touchdown on New England soil, the power of three happened. I came, I saw, and you made an impression. One of you took one look at my fancy, trying to impress you, 3-inch heels, tromping through the snow. And 2 hours later, you showed up with a pair of winter boots saying, "You're a size 9, right?" The B&B where we stayed locked me out. So after interviewing with the vestry, one of you who I'm looking at right now drove me there and said, "Don't you dare get out of this car, Marjorie." And you tromped through bushes and 2 feet of snow to the bedroom window, and you begged and hollered until someone, not my ex-husband, woke up and unlocked the door. Upon entering this building, I noticed my grandmother's favorite Bible quote outside the nave. But what sealed the deal was being shown the nursery and seeing this stunning wall mural painted by Lane Krikorian and Dottie Koch. God rest her soul, complete with, of course, a perfect likeness of Dottie's And so way back when I thought, surely this could be my spiritual home. Here I am, Lord, yet is it I, Lord, sit? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me.
Words for word prayers Magnificat. You know, actions always have consequences. And Hannah's actions, Hannah's sacred sacrifice, results in her child, Samuel, not Eli's two sons, being the one who heard God's voice. And really, for me, Samuel is one of the few greats in the Bible who really doesn't botch much up. He's a prophet, a judge, a truth teller, an anointer of Saul, the first king of Israel. And true, as with all of us, Samuel's life wasn't a picnic. But despite whatever obstacles that were put in his way, he saw his life as a divine circle tale, choosing to return again and again in word and deed to his maker and say with his life, "Lord, I am yours alone. Use me. Here I am." None of you know this, but over the 2011 Martin Luther King weekend, one of the best cheerleaders of my life, a man named Jeff Keffer, died while I was visiting you. He was the last one to put me in the car to come here and greet you all. One minute I saw him at age 48. That afternoon he went riding with his 12-year-old son, and the next minute he was dead. Upon returning from New Hampshire, I immediately went to visit the family, and entering their kitchen, I found the middle child, Abby, at war with her mother, saying, "I will speak at Dad's funeral, and you can't stop me." And her mother looked towards me, saying, "Marjorie, as her chaplain, you tell Abby she's too young to speak at her father's funeral."
Up.
and difficult work. And yet, you're still here. You're still loving and praying and listening and blessing and giving and serving. Do not be passive, but be active, engaged, and faithful. For dear, here I am, life is a prayer spoken by God.
Standing this direction so all the Zoom people will not have to see our rears, just so you know. That was my plan. At the beginning of my ministry, you gave me many things in trust and a charge as to how to use them. Now I leave these and other things with you, the ministers of Grace Episcopal Church, the congregation, and lay leaders. Shelley continue to share the wisdom within the Book of Common Prayer and our scriptures and ensure that the prayers of God's people and along with the ministry of the clergy, the sacraments, and the church continue in this place.
I will look outside.
Oh, amen. Mark and Carter, continue to use these hymnals and ensure that the praise of God and prayers to God continue in this place. Amen.
Amen.
Amy, receive these keys and ensure that the doors of this place remain open to all people. Amen. She said, I will.
And in her heart with God's help. Teddy, receive, receive these remaining discretionary account checks and debit card, and continue to be a place and people that seeks to serve and help others. Amen. Amy and Teddy, receive these, the parish bylaws and vestry norms. May this congregation continue to be governed in accordance with them and in communion with our bishop. Amen.
Amen.
Lynn. Barnaby. My brain is going funky. It's terrible. Michael, St. Michael. Mo, thank you. COVID fog. I know you all by name. Continue to use this water for the baptismal font and ensure that this remains a place where people are loved and brought into the family of God through the baptism of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
This is the front. Keep up with that clay. Oh, I don't think so. Let all these be signs of the ministry that is yours and the bishop's in this place.
Let us pray. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all, and provider of grace to all who toil together in the hope of meaningful living, continue your saving work through your Spirit in our midst.
Give grace to your servants, O Lord.
Grant that our lives and Marjorie's new call may continue to be instruments for serving the common good, with time for leisure, for new growth, and service.
Give grace to your servants, O Lord.
Grant Marjorie, as she leaves the accomplishments and trials of this congregation, a sense of gratitude for those who have shared this journey, both at Grace Church, in this community, the church, and the world.
Give grace to your servants, O Lord.
Give Marjorie thankfulness for all who have supported her in life's journey, especially her children, Fiona and Zachary, her parents and her siblings, as well as for all those who have shared in her spiritual journey, that she may continually use insights from her path to help others know and serve God.
Give grace to your servants, O Lord.
Grant Marjorie wisdom and understanding in the ordering of her new ministry elsewhere, that she may be blessed with a positive, hopeful perspective, so that future years may be valued and productive in service to you.
Give grace to your servants, O Lord.
Give forgiveness to us and to Marjorie for all things done and left undone in our common life.
Give grace to your servants, O Lord.
Grant to the people of Grace Episcopal Church the vision to continue on God's journey, to fulfill the mission of Grace Church, that all people might know God and love each other through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Give grace to your servants, O Lord.
Grant to this congregational family the awareness of those who have gone before us, a thankfulness for their abiding faith, and a willingness to ever seek the kingdom of God both in this place and beyond its walls.
Give grace to your servants, O Lord.
The peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
and also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, because in the mystery of the Word made flesh, you have caused a new light to shine in our hearts, to give the knowledge of your glory in the face of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
gifts of God, for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith. The Thanksgiving.
Christ, the bread of heaven.
Amen.
Christ, the bread of heaven.
make haste to be kind. And may the blessing of the one who made us, who loves us, and who walks the way with us still, the one holy and undivided Trinity, be with us this day and remain with us always.
Amen.
On the 11th day of July in 2011, I started my ministry with Grace Church. As your rector, I have, with God's help and the best of my abilities, exercised this trust and accepted its privileges and responsibilities. After prayer and careful consideration, it now seems to me that I should leave this charge and move to Transfiguration in Derry, New Hampshire. And I publicly state that my tenure as rector of Grace Church ends this day. Do you, the people of Grace Episcopal Church, recognize and,
on behalf of the bishop, do you, the people of Grace Episcopal Church, recognize and accept the conclusion of this pastoral relationship?
We do.
Hear it.
If anybody can use this, it's a straight rail.
material. Stairlift, and it's available, and I need to get it out of my house by 28. So I have some information. If anybody knows anybody that needs it, it's pretty simple to uninstall, and I just want to share that with you this morning.
Okay, we have a reception upstairs, the coffee hour with Marjorie, and there are blank cards up there if you'd like to write a note for. We greatly appreciate all her service here and wish her Godspeed at the Transfiguration. If you wish to give money, see me or Teddy or send it to Eileen Suckley. And also a brief note that our annual meeting is going to be on February 18th. We'll be posting that soon and information about that. Any other